Hello people, welcome back to my channel. The topic for today's video is activation functions. So in the last video we saw different types of algorithms like backpropagation algorithm, the delta rule, chain rule, etc. and many other things. So in today's video let's see what are the activation functions, that is the main non-linear part that comes across the neural unit and why we require it mainly for deep learning. So essentially we know that our neural network looks like something, and say let us consider some structure like this, and you know that each part is comprised of two sections, that is non-linear and linear part. So we mainly employ some sigmoid function over here. So essentially why we require this activation function, or we can have only this linear part, so that's essential, right? No, well, it's not the same way. So since our human brain, we have two right brains and left brain, so similar is the case with neural unit as well. So that neural network has also a non-linear part, so that is an indispensable portion. So whenever you have a unit, you have both linear part and non-linear part. Now this non-linear part satisfies two different properties in nature. So the very first is it should be non-linear, and second is that it should be differentiable. Now since we are talking about non-linear part, then why we call it as non-linear, or why it has to satisfy non-linearity? So before this sigmoid functions, we have this MCP, that is McCulloch and Pitts neuron. So in that, what they used is they used a step function which looked something like this. So this step function has one property, or there is one limitation, is that it is not smooth or it is not differentiable. So whenever you have a neural unit, or whenever you have a neuron, you should have a non-linear part, and which should satisfy two both of these properties. That is, first it is non-linearity, and from there it goes to differentiable. Now why you require differentiable, or why we are saying that an activation function which should be deployed here should be differentiable? Because say you have a large pool of networks like convolutional neural networks, and there you have n number of different layers. So if there needs to be a case like if you want to just go back to each weight and then you want to update, so how would you do that? So that we have essentially seen in a backpropagation algorithm. So that's why we say that if we use our non-linear function, that should be essentially differentiable, else that's a waste of having some non-linear part which is not differentiable. Now in the literature for neural networks, we have two categories of activation functions. So one section says it is a piecewise linear function, and the other section is called as smooth functions. So in piecewise linear functions, we primarily have step function. Then you have something called as ReLU, that is rectified linear unit. Then you have a variant of ReLU, that is leaky ReLU. You have parametric ReLU. And then in smooth functions, you have something called as sigmoid. That is, we know that is from our logistic regression. Then we have something called as hyperbolic tangent, that is tan h function. And then what we have is we have something called as swish. So swish is a combination of your sigmoid and tan h, so which is just known monotonic function. and it will outperform all other activation functions which are present in the literature for neural networks. So now what we do is we'll do a comparative overview of the very first function, that is we have the step function, or why it is always suggested that you don't go with a step function. So this part, essentially the non-linear part, if you have this step function, it looks something like this. So say this is my coordinate and this is my function. So step function has some value, like it has 0 and it is 1. So it's like, moreover, like you are enabling some gate or enabling some unit. So whether that has to operate or not. So 1 means you will fire the output, and 0 means you don't fire. So firing is done in case, like if that particular linear computation exceeds some particular threshold. So say it is w1 x1 plus w2 x2, and if it is greater than some threshold, say then in that case or in that event you trigger a 1, else in the other case, if it's less than that threshold, you don't fire any function or any output. So merely you can say like there is not much particular activity that is being carried out by your step function. So it is like just you are bypassing, or you're opening some gate to some particular function, just you're opening and closing a guard which is kept at this particular portion. So that is not merely changing anything. So it can also be seen that this is not linear. So this particular step function is linear in nature. So our very first criteria of activation function is not being satisfied. So forget about being differentiable, it is not even linear. So that is not even non-linear. So it is a linear function, so you cannot deploy that into your algorithms or for designing your neural network. And also, say this is our function, if we want to take the differentiative, so say we are computing f prime of z. Say this is z of some computations, and if you just visualize this, the derivative or the very first primary derivative would be lying somewhere here. So say this is minus z and this is plus z. So the derivative is 0 at this particular point. So essentially it is not linear, and so you have some breaks at this particular two points. So it is not smooth. So there is a sudden shift from positive 1 to 0 that is happening. So essentially you can't deploy this, and it will not learn any non-linearity which is present in your real life. So most or all of the examples in our real world are non-linear in nature. So if you are putting any activation function which is not learning this non-linearity, then what is the use of having this step function in your neural network? So that is the main reason why we don't go with step functions, and we have some other variants which you can see, sigmoid, hyperbolic, you can use swish function, ReLU and its variants. So there we can use activation functions, and you can achieve your activity in a much better way. So well, that was all regarding the activation function, that is the very first step function in deep learning. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you want to get educated on this video, please do like, share, comment, and if you're new to this channel, please consider subscribing. Thank you very much for watching this video.